In this video, I will explain how you can use path analysis object to analyze attendance to marketing events. This demo will use SAS Visual Analytics to visualize data and SAS Viya Jobs to generate data in a structure that is usable by the path analysis object. The SAS Viya Job provides functionalities that are similar to the ones of the SAS 9 store processes. SAS Viya Jobs are executed from the web through HTTP requests. The requests are sent to the SAS Job execution endpoint, and behind the scene, the jobs are executed on the SAS compute server, which is started by the launcher server. You can build the jobs using SAS Studio or the SAS Job execution web application, SAS Studio being the preferred option. If you are familiar with SAS 9 stored processes, the GS begin and GS end autocall macros will be familiar to you. They were named STP begin and STP end in SAS 9. A job is a combination of different things. A job prompt written in HTML or in XML, a job definition which contains the information about the prompt to use, the parameters and the SAS code. The job parameters are used to pass data from the prompt to the SAS code and appear in the code as macro variables. It's now time for a small demo and more explanation. This is the final report that we will generate. You can see here on the left-hand side the event IDs. They also appear here at the top. We have our path analysis object over here and a data-driven content object here, which is responsible to execute the job and to receive data from the selection over here. The job will then generate the data that is displayed in the path analysis object. So if we change the values over here, you see that the objects are automatically refreshed. And we will generate data in order to refresh the data that is used behind the scene for this path analysis object. The job execution is done on the compute server, which is started on demand when the user clicks on the generate data. You see now that the report object has been updated. If I change back the values and click on generate data, a new job is executed, generating and refreshing the data that is loaded into CAS, and it will automatically refresh when the job ends over here and appear in the object. So what's happening behind the scenes? So we have here the different objects. I'm in edit mode. We have a list prompt, a data-driven content object. The list prompt will pass information to the data-driven content object and the button bar. The button bar appears here on the top of the object. The data-driven content object does not interact with anything, but it contains the information about the job that should be executed. The job execution is used to execute the job, and we will see the code right now. So let's go to SAS Studio, where we have developed our code. So this is a job definition. The job definition is based on SAS code, HTML form, and a few parameters. So we have created the code. In this case, the code is using CAS data. So we are defining a CAS session. Then we are defining a few temporary tables. So we will drop them for each execution to be sure that we are using the latest data. Then we create a potential table, meaning that we create a table which contains all the users that were registered to at least one of the event, and we merge that with the different events so that we have all the possible attendees. Then we have an attendance table, and this attendance table is generating a status, and the status comes from the data that is already available in our system. So for all the events where the people were attending, but if somebody was not attending to one of the events, we should display that the user was not registered to that event. Then we promote the table attendance to make sure that it's available for between sessions. And then we finally close the CAS session. We have also an HTML form, and the HTML form is a standard HTML page where we define the head section and a few objects. The objects is the button to generate the data, the one we clicked before, the loader section, and that loader section we display that the data is loading or that the data is loaded. And then we implement a few functions to get the interaction. So when we have the list object filtering the data-driven content object, we are receiving a message. And on the reception of that message, we execute a function, and this function checks if we have data for that event. And if we have data, we will then pass this data as the selection, being the selection that we did in the list object. Then using this selection, we are executing the job. And to execute the job, we are passing an endpoint, so the endpoint for the SAS job execution. We are also passing parameters in the URL for the program, which is here a default value because we are running the SAS job execution. Then we execute an action, in this case the execute action. We pass the interactions, and the interactions is the selection, so a list of IDs that we are defining. Then we build the URL for the job execution and we call it. As soon as we get data or the job ends, we are displaying a message that the data is loaded. So this is technically what we see in our interface, that we have here the loaded button that does appear. There is a simple trick that we need to use is that when we have updated the data, there you should refresh the path analysis object. And to do that, you can do it in the options, and to refresh periodically the data, you set the 1 second, for example, if you want to refresh the data every second. This is not happening in edit mode as we are now, but if we go back to the view mode, we have the refresh functionality that is active behind the scene. So that's it for the demo. So you can find more information about jobs and how to use them within SAS Visual Analytics on SAS communities and also on the SAS users YouTube channel. We have different blogs about the prompts that are used within the Viya Jobs. So how to build Viya Jobs using task prompt or HTML prompts. We have also a blog where I present how we can add a rating functionality to a visual analytics report. And also there is some kind of specific configuration that should be handled on the compute session to make the compute server reusable between calls to speed up the process of loading the data. Thanks for watching, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.